Hello friends, this is Yogesh Joshi. Today we are at a place called Amostra Solutions Private Limited. It's located in Gurgaon, Haryana, which is part of India obviously. And my name is Yogesh Joshi and I have with me Mr. Arun Prabhu. You are the Director, Sales and Operations for this exciting company which is almost 10 years old now.
That's 6 years.
6 years old, so Amostra Solutions. Welcome Arun.
Thank you, Yogesh.
Wonderful. So can you tell us a little brief about what Amostra is all about?
Yeah, basically Amostra started as a technology company. Mm-hmm. We were into smartphones, tablet manufacturing, and it graduated into an opportunity company.
Okay.
So basically what we have evolved is we are now using technology to give opportunities to the masses, especially the rural segment.
Okay.
When I say technology, means if we see today, the world is going digital. Mm-hmm. And everything, all the opportunities now lie digital. Even after the post-pandemic, we have embraced this digital world very fast. Mm-hmm. It has actually, you know, taken a rocket launch. Mm-hmm. Prior to pandemic, these are some of the plus points of pandemics. Mm-hmm. Prior to pandemic, it was very difficult to go digital. It was very difficult to convince people to go into the platform, and you know, mm-hmm. so logistics was a very big challenge.
Okay.
And that was what we were all aiming at, that how to use digital platform mm-hmm. to create opportunities across
okay.
our masses.
Okay.
So basically where we are planning, we aim at giving technical support to give opportunities to people who want mm-hmm. either maybe through job opportunities to business opportunities, whichever, you know, aspects there.
So essentially, if I were to understand this correctly, you are leveraging technology,
yes.
as in, let's say, digital, for instance, or as in, let's say, software,
yes.
any
yes.
kind of, you know, these kind of platforms to provide services to the
yeah.
rural part
absolutely,
of India,
absolutely.
Right?
Yes, yes.
Okay, wonderful. So then my next question is, as to what kind of initiatives or programs that you are currently, you know, leading as part of this initiative?
So when Amostra actually started, we had five verticals.
Mm-hmm.
You see, the first vertical is whenever we talk about digital world, we talk that there has to be a device.
Okay.
Because without a device, there's
obviously.
Not, you know. So we started manufacturing tablets, smartphones,
mm-hmm.
signages.
Okay.
And the second vertical is you need some database, because without any database,
mm-hmm.
there's not, you can't go digital without any database.
Okay.
So we were into verification, we were into database management. Then the third thing which we require is connected screens and connected devices.
Okay.
So when you say connected devices, like GPS equipment, trackers, sensors.
IoT based. Okay.
Then you require a software app which should connect
everything.
So that's the
all
four,
the devices.
Four, all the devices. Because
okay.
if you don't have...
if they don't talk with each other, then it's no
other. If they don't shake hands with each other, then what's the use of
people? Okay.
So it said, see, most of the social media is filled with data.
Mm-hmm.
But this data has got no relevance if it is not, you know, concretized into something which is deliverable.
Okay.
And the fourth thing is associations.
Okay.
You know, associate with different organizations so that you create a use case.
Okay.
So this is what we aimed at.
Mm-hmm.
And this technology is if it is presented to a layman.
Mm-hmm.
See, for example, a layman doesn't understand digital world. Layman doesn't understand everything. When I say layman, say for a person who's doing job, maybe
mm-hmm.
a field sales executive,
mm-hmm.
or maybe a shopkeeper.
Mm-hmm.
Now, for shopkeeper, it's all brick and mortar.
Mm-hmm.
It's not digital. So he's used to a brick and mortar kind of a, you know, business environment. For him, digital is something which, you know, he's afraid of.
Okay.
But if he has to compete or if he has to survive in a digital world, he has to be plugged in into
that
the mainstream, in the mainstream.
Right.
Now, if we go them and if we tell them that this is a solution, this is what it is like, for example, most mm-hmm. of the things which are not app-based are very easy to use.
Mm-hmm.
So when we give any solution,
mm-hmm.
easy to use.
Mm-hmm.
So for him, for example, if I have to drive a car, I don't have to,
mm-hmm.
you know the thermodynamics or the compression, combustion or anything. I don't
mm-hmm.
have to know
mm-hmm.
this. Fine.
Okay.
What I have to know is just how to use the key.
Mm-hmm.
Where is the accelerator? Where is the brake?
Okay.
Similarly, when we use technology and we give a use case, and that use case is easy to use,
mm-hmm.
that is how we connect. And one of the initiatives which we have started is Hum Hai.
Okay.
Hum Hai is our opportunity, is our...
Hum Hai, can you translate this into English?
Yeah. So So hum hai in English means we are there. So the thought process behind it was that any type of requirements which you have, whether you have service requirements, whether you have technology requirements, product requirement, any type of requirements, whether you have job opportunities you want or you want business opportunities, we are there for you. And Hame Seva Kendra is aimed at giving all that under one roof, under one thing, which is backed up by a technology platform. So whether someone wants jobs, which is presently due to COVID, that's one of the most precious commodities right now. Everyone needs a job. So we are trying to create job opportunities pan India for people. Though job verticals have changed maybe, but then yes, the opportunity still remains. A lot of job opportunities are there which have been created post-pandemic as well. Likewise, we also want to give people self-employment opportunities where they can open their own Seva Kendra. Doesn't require much of an investment. It is sub 1 lakh rupees investment on that, and anyone can earn at least 15 to 20,000 rupees minimum per month. We have a lot of services under that. We have GST services, we have job services, verification services, and then we have our products like LEDs, solar lanterns, solar products, digital signages, battery banks, smartphones, tablets, education tablets under the vertical of EduOne. So, and presently we have all gone digital. So education has gone digital, which is a very good boon, so that now rural can access education. Previously, building up a school in the rural area was a huge investment. Now, since post-pandemic, people have gone digital. So it has facilitated getting deeper into the rural segment to deliver them educations. Now a kid somewhere in a remote area with a tablet and an internet connection can access to latest technology, can access to education, can access to training programs, can do work from home, which is a new culture which we have evolved. So they can actually work from home. So we say that you don't come to the opportunity. We say we deliver the opportunity to you. That was the idea behind Hum Hai. And this was our brainchild, me and Ashish. We had been working for this for, I think, so come 7 or 8 years, more than that. And now it has actually, you know, culminated into a strong concept, and we've already started working on it. A lot of Seva Kendras are opening, and we plan to set up at least 1,000 Seva Kendras in this financial year.
Okay. Yeah. Wonderful. That's a pretty ambitious target that you have taken in terms of setting up 1,000 Seva Kendras across India.
Yeah.
Do you also plan to go international, or do you want to keep this as a national kind of initiative?
No, we would always want to go global.
Okay.
But presently the opportunities in India is so immense.
Okay.
India still has not been captured.
See,
in India, when I say 1,000 will go into the metros only.
Mm-hmm.
When we talk about the rural segment, mm-hmm. we see an expanse of at least 40,000-50,000, more than that rather, I would say.
Okay, because we have seen countries like, Far East countries, or let's say African countries, similar in the position where, or Southeast Asia,
yes,
we talk about.
Yes, yes.
Those countries also have similar problems, especially in the rural side of it.
Yeah.
So I'm sure this kind of a platform may definitely help those countries as well in the long run.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Okay. So as we speak, Arun, you spoke about 1,000 as a target for this particular year, which I'm assuming from April to March, right?
Yeah.
The Indian calendar year. And what is the current number that is currently?
See, the current number is till March. Till March, we are into the concept development stage. Rather, I will not say concept development stage. Rather, going through the evolution.
It's a pilot. Which is
so what we are targeting is by April we are targeting 25 such centers.
I see.
Where we go through the learning curve.
Okay.
And once we have done our total learning,
mm-hmm.
evolution is a process, it will keep on
Absolutely.
Going. But once we have a model which is sustainable,
mm-hmm.
then it's all about duplication.
Okay.
And it's not an experiment.
Multiplication. Okay.
Yeah.
Wonderful. So, Arun, this is a universal problem, I believe, which everybody is facing, passing through. How has your company, overcome this situation where we see 100% kind of a seating capacity in your office,
mm-hmm.
which means that you guys have, kept this COVID virus outside your offices, premises, and which is why you and your team is confident in coming to office daily. Can you share some tricks as to how did you manage to overcome this scenario?
See, first of all, every bad thing has got a good side of it. Pre-pandemic, I would not, never wish that this happens again, but then again, we have to always see the brighter side of the things.
True.
Pre-pandemic, we were so much busy with our regular affairs that we couldn't give much thought to this concept, consolidating the back end, consolidating the concept, getting with the collaterals and everything. So first thing which we used was when the pandemic came, we were actually clueless. Like everyone, we were all clueless what to do. We didn't know whether when, how long this pandemic is going to last. But then after some time, we stood up again and we said, what best can we do right now? So we are all working from home. So what the best thing which we can do is we can all create the backends, create the systems. And this 6, 7, 8 months which have been there working from home, we consolidated all the backend jobs and everything, creating a platform for that. That was a reality check for us. So we are thankful that this has helped us. And now since people are coming back, we still have people, few people coming, working from office, some people working from home. But yes, we have graduated into consolidating the whole work environment, which was not there. Because see, there were IT companies which had those infrastructures. But most of the companies have been taken by surprise. They didn't have the time to develop the infrastructure. So we evolved how to create a balance between work from home and work from office, because there are challenges of working from home also, and there are now challenges of working from office also. So yes, there is always an opportunity with every
Quite happening. Interesting and motivating for all the folks who might be viewing this video in their leisure time or in their vocational times. But yes, this is something which is brave and motivational. That COVID will definitely be there, because nobody knows its departure time, right? Or the date. But we guys have to be equally equipped with all the safety protocols and guidelines which are laid down by the government, and try to act as normal people or people who are were there during their pre-COVID times. I think that is the way to go. And with this, let me thank you, Arun, for joining us today.
Thank you.
We wish you and your team all the best in your current
thank
day,
you. Thank
as
you.
Well
thank
as future interviews.
Thank you so
this
much.
This is Yogesh Joshi signing off.
Thank you.
Thanks. Bye.
Namaskar.
Bye.